Alright, I'm back with another speaker. This one's a little bit different from all the others. I don't know, some people like the way it looks, some people don't like the way it looks. Me, I wasn't really too big of a fan of how it looks. I wasn't really a fan of it, but this thing sounds great. I think there's more than one of these versions too. They have some with these crappy speakers, and then they have some with some really good speakers. And I was going to do an unboxing because I still have the box, you know. But there's really nothing in the box but the actual speaker itself. So I just thought I wouldn't even do it. I believe on the bottom of this it says how many watts this thing is. Let's check that out real quick. So we got 15 watts. When I checked it out online, I did some research on it after, I was very happy, pleased with the sound. It actually has a little more than 15 watts, but, I mean, when it comes to its base, it's 15 watts. But when it comes to all the total, it has a little more because these, you know how these count too. So it's got 25 watts. That's what it is. Because I think these are, I think it's a 25 watt. I'm pretty sure. Because when I read the manual, it said something about these being, if I have 15, I think these are 10 each or 5, something like that. But it adds up to 25. So let's go ahead and take a look at this speaker. A little bit closer. It comes with a free strap, which is pretty cool. It gets longer if you need to make it longer. You can see it here. If you pull this upward here, it'd get longer. This is what it looks like in the back of it, which is pretty good. Nothing major. You got your nice subwoofer here. And on this side, this is your passive radiator. So you got a 5.5 inches of passive radiator right here, which works really good. It bumps good. It moves perfect. I've opened this up and also taken a look at it. And I wanted to see, because when I first got it, I kind of felt no power going into the speaker, but it was moving, but I didn't hear any voice coil or anything. So, I opened it up really fast because it's really easy to open. It's just a few screws and it's open. And I seen that this is a really nice passive radiator inside. I mean, really nice. And a nice, decent subwoofer right here. And it's got bass control. If you look at that, it says bass. So you can go ahead and let's see if I get this to come in. Okay, so you got your USB. Okay, so you got your mode button, forward and rewind, of course, play. Everything works great. You don't have to worry about any buttons dubbing as two buttons because it already has its volume and bass separated. So you don't have to worry about dubbing two buttons and accidentally changing your music instead of putting it up. So let's go ahead and get this guy on. It goes by many names too. I seen it like with a billion different names on it. So it's one of those speakers that goes by lots of names. It does come equipped with a light on the other side of this, so there is lights on it. So let's go ahead and turn this on. So let's go ahead and turn it on. So this is how you turn it on, by just moving the volume.
Is ready to pair. The Bluetooth device is connected successfully.
Okay, so it is like really fast when it comes to its connection. And if you see, you could see the lights are on now. Pretty cool feature. It's not too bad. So then you just hold down the mode button to turn the lights off. So we'll go ahead and turn all the bass all the way down, and it's already connected to my phone, so we'll just go over to some same old bass songs, you know, see what it sounds like. Let's do the bass test, a heavy bass test first, see what it sounds like. Alright, so that's full blast on my cell phone. So this is it with no bass on. You can see it's not moving, it's not doing anything. But if I go ahead and start adding bass.
Warning, heavy bass test by different Kevin. 3, 2.
Sounds pretty good.
1.
Let's add some more bass.
Maximum bass activated.
Look at that thing go. Man, look at that. And I mean, this thing is powerful. It may not look too nice looking, but man, it really makes up for it with the sound. It's a hi-fi sound too. So here's our passive radiator on this side. Let's see if I can get that better for us. It. And I mean, the bass sounds great. If you guys, I don't have this connected to some dope kind of microphone. But I'm telling you, if you guys were to put your earphones on right now, you should be able to hear the bass. I won't put it too close to it so it doesn't sound like crap. But it should sound pretty good, even just like right now, with your earphones on. So it's working. It sounds great, too. And I only have it on volume. It's maxed out. So I'll go ahead and put that down. I think my battery may be dead. I haven't used this thing in a few days. I mean, not even a few days. It's been about a good week. Ever since I got the Sony radio, I kind of stopped using it. So it's kind of dead. Let's go to something else here. Okay, here's another song. Have it on 12. We'll leave it on 20. So it's on 20 right now. Let's add some more bass. Let's add all the bass. Put it this way in this corner here. I bet you guys can probably hear it if you have your earphones on. I have it in the corner. The speaker that's actually on, I have it facing that way into the corner, and it kind of gives me a lot of more bass like this, a lot more. Got a stupid arcade there. And there's the rest of my game stuff. See that? I have some more game stuff over there. The whole Game Boy family. Some more over there. And tons more all around the house. Yeah, look at that. Sega 32X. Anyways, let's go back over here. Let's hear that bass. Man, it's subbing. Check that out. another Bluetooth speaker I'm going to show you guys too. I got this one a while back, used, has a big old passive radiator on the other side of it. So this is it. I'll go ahead and put the volume down. So you see, it sounds great. I'm going to try to forward track here from it. And it goes all the way up to 30. Hi-fi sound. Man, this thing works great. Turn the lights off, turn them back on. Not bad.
She is in my head like a nightmare. Shut up, every club I can find her. Never been a fool, cause I like her.
Stuck in my bed, tripping on things that you said. Could wake up the dead. She, I don't wanna wait one another. I'm scared thinking that I found my lover. Party all drinks, still haunt my dreams. 25 years of my life, it seems.
So this is a passive radiator, the one I'm showing you. The actual speaker that moves is over there. So you got three speakers that actually move and one passive radiator.
We'll be right back. Cabro.
Not bad. So if you guys see this slipping for 30, I bought it for 35. Don't get it for anything higher. Well, I would say, 40 tops. So there you have it. Really good speaker. But make sure when you buy it, there's two versions. There's some with party speakers right here. So they're the loud version. They don't bump. They're just all paper flat speakers. You don't want to get that version. You want to get the based out one like this. This is the one they're trying to copy. Very good. Very, very good speaker. Bumps like crazy. It'll outbeat any JBL except for the boombox. So it's pretty, pretty bassy. Thanks a lot for watching.